Hey, what's going on, guys? I just turned on the remote here, at least the countdown timer, because we have the Blade mQX mini little quadcopter in X mode configuration, and it's set up with a few different things. A quick note before we actually start flying here and kill the battery is that I've gone through and programmed the Spektrum DX6i. So look, if I go hard top right on this control stick, look at the controls on the screen here, hardly moving at all. That's because I set up some exponential and different dual rates, but if I flip one switch here, you'll notice I can go all out in any direction there, and that's not even full direction. So that's something cool that that you can do with these more advanced remotes like the DX6i. It's not something that you're going to find typically on the ready-to-fly models at the cheap remotes, and I recommend that you guys do get a bind-and-fly capable remote like the Spektrums, because they are able to be programmed and they'll give you a much easier and funner flying experience. So maybe worth looking into, guys, just something to consider. But they're also great because you could buy the bind and fly models after you have a nice remote, and you could save a little bit of money per model. It's usually cheaper to do that because they could drop the price not having to put a transmitter in there. Anyway, so we got two things, two sort of rates that we can go at. We're going to start over here on the slow mode. We'll take off. And you'll notice how easy it is to keep steady here. We'll sort of spin around in place. And just look how easy this is. If I were to mount a camera to this mQX, which I plan on doing, the real one that I've ordered, which would be here today, actually. The camera won't be here for a month, though. It's one of those 808 ones from China or something. It takes like 20 business days to arrive. But, yeah, that will give you a much smoother image if you got these lower rates and such. It's also much easier to fly, man. Look at this. I can go hard on a stick, not have to worry about it really going out of control. It does build up some speed, but then you can really get it back in control. Simple as that. Now maybe you want to go a little bit more advanced when you're flying. Say you flip one switch here, and you'll notice we could do some flips, back flips, shoot up in the air a little bit more, gain some altitude, some side flips, or we just go all out. Get some good speed. Oops, I flipped it and I've crashed it. Let's not do that today. Find that sweet spot in the acrobatic mode. Go all the way out there. And then bring it back towards us. Got about 5 minutes left on this battery for flight time, it's saying. It's a great thing about these remotes. They give you like a countdown timer or a count-up timer, so you can tell, is my battery ready to die, or is this thing just going to drop out of the air? Not something you're going to get on the cheap remotes. You want to know at least how your flight time is and program around that. Most people have a standalone timer, kitchen timer or something. But having a remote like the Spektrum DX6i or something higher than that with a countdown timer in it is very, very convenient. So there you have it, guys. Those little dual rates. I'll show you guys how I set that up in the future, but it's not too hard. One switch, go back to easy flying mode, flip it back again, and I got all the control I need. And it'll be much harder to keep in control with this, but that's more acrobatic. I plan on staying on the smooth, easy mode. But yeah, I'm really liking this Phoenix flight software. Unfortunately, you guys can't hear the system audio. It's not the best anyway. I normally run quite an advanced audio setup on my my computer here. It's not just the standard sound card. I run $500 sound cards, which are meant for pro recording studios, and I pair them with an actual analog mixer. I got my mixer decided to act up, so I'm sending them back to Behringer for repair under warranty, and right now, you're just on one really expensive sound card, which means I can talk and record. Yeah, we can just hover in place here. This is how easy this is to control. Man, I'm loving this. But yeah, eventually we'll get system audio back. May take a while. That's not going to stop any of my other videos, because I got the camcorder and I record audio directly to that. but these screen cap things, well, we may find a way to sort of fix system audio so I can record that. Maybe do it in post. There's always a way around it. But that's another update. So yeah, mQX. This guy will be on my doorstep today. I'll see how it compares to the software. I love the software. It's a great way to learn on, or maybe have crappy weather outside or something like that. It's a great way to see how models react. And we'll see how they react in person shortly when we get this thing in the air. Got an extra battery for it too. That way we don't run out of like 15-minute flight or something like that. Won't drop out of the air and me not have to do anything anymore for the rest of the day. So I think they take about, I don't know, 40 minutes to charge a battery pack like this. We'll see how it works. I mean, I'll give you guys a review. I'm liking this Phoenix software. That's a quick review for you. I could definitely recommend it. A lot of people do. Free updates for different models and locations, stuff like that. But yeah, let's bring this into land here, sort of close down and show you guys some of the landscape here on this particular map that we've got here. Sort of see the city line over there, the skyscape, whatever you want to call it, cityscape. Bunch of cool houses, great detail. It looks like they actually have a real photo panorama was taken, creative out of it. Whatever you want to call it. And some really interesting ways to fly around these things. I can go behind some of these castles and whatnot. But it's just interesting seeing all the details of these real locations without actually having to go there in person. But I thought I'd show you guys some of this map, and we'll start wrapping this up. So as I bring this guy into land, I want to thank you guys for commenting, rating, subscribing. If you have any questions, feel free to put them in the comments below. And I try my best to answer each and every one of those. If you have any questions on like the radio that I use, the DX6i, the software, maybe some of my other videos, hey, comment section, always open for your thoughts, feelings, or whatever. So that said, I'm Dave from Sonic Orb Studios, guys. More videos to come shortly. Thank you for watching, and I'll see you next time.